I mean, I had hopes for these two palettes and I knew I would make it work even if they're not that great, but I don't know my expectations for this, so that's the reason I wanted to try this one on camera, because colors, especially such bright colors, are really difficult to make. So in the end, if you like what you see, then make sure you hit the subscribe button and ring the notification bell so that you will get notified every time I post, and even comment down below and tell me what you think about these palettes if you've used them. So yeah, let's get started. So my base is done off camera and I'm just going to fill my brows. I'm using the Benefit Precisely My Brow Pencil and I am just going to fill the starting part. And for the base of my eyeshadow, I'm going to use this Instant Age Rewind Concealer from Maybelline. I've done multiple looks using this concealer and they've always worked out really well. So I want to use something which I'm familiar with. So I'm just going to apply this on the lid and I'm even going to carve out my brow using the same concealer. I'm in a very warm mood, you can already see I wore an orange dress, orange lip, and I even thought about an orange look. So let's see how it goes. In my head, it looks really beautiful, but while execution, I'm sure there will be some problem because I have such bright colors. I mean, all the colors in the palette are bright. So hopefully it'll work out. We have to see. If you're not interested in seeing my look, like how I do my look, then I'll put a timestamp here. You can definitely go there. I think I'll put swatches and the end review on my thoughts right there. So jump to the timestamp if you want, and I'm going to start off with this now. So let's quickly go through the details about the palette. First of all, not sponsored video, I bought this myself. So I bought the three of these palettes. So these retail, I think they have an offer. I don't know if they have offer running right now. So I bought these from a website called hawkmakeup.com. So they have like various other brands as well, not just this. They have Makeup Revolution. They have they have different things, and that website is beautiful. It has number of offers running on constantly. So one day I randomly checked the site and they had this three palettes for $999, and they had various other combos as well, but this one was only available in this combo. So I got this and I am pretty happy with the deal. Bro, $999 and three palettes for $999 is an amazing deal. And so each palette also retails for $599. So if I bought these individually, then they would be like $1,800, but I got them for $999, which is an amazing deal. So the palette I'm going in is called Birthday Cake, and it has bright colors. These colors speak to my soul. So now the real test here is for the mattes. The shimmers usually work in most of the palettes, so I want to test most of the matte colors. So I'm going to go in with orange, blue, and yellow is also really tricky to make, so I want to try yellow as well. So first I'm just picking on this shade. I'm using a BH Cosmetics Studio Pro brush number 8, and I'm just picking this bright orange. It's like a more coral orange. It's like not pure orange, it's more coral and stuff like that. So I'm just picking that on the brush and I'm going to pack that on the lid. Now this is a real test. I hope it works. I'm hoping this would work because a lot of people ask me a good bright eyeshadow palette. It's affordable, available in India. So if this works, then you've got one girl. I mean, that is not bad, right? I'm impressed. Now the real test is going to be blending. And for blending, for this pigmentation and right? If I have to take 2 more minutes to blend the shadow, I don't really mind because it's such a good deal. So I'm just trying to blend the edges so that I can go in with another color. Until now, I have no complaints. Next, I'm just going to take this pink and I'm going to try to diffuse that color. So I'm just trying to mix that coral orange in that pink. I wish the pink was a little more lighter. So what I'm going to actually do is I'm going to take this color. This is from this Autumn Spice palette. And I'm just going to take that color and diffuse the edges. So it's basically, it's like a very light shade. It's almost the shade of my concealer. So it's just going to soften those edges a lot more and give that very strong to light gradient. Now, it's not only this palette, no matter what palette it is, color is always buildable. So you have to like keep building, because once you blend it off, the pigment is going to reduce. So you'll have to go in with a little more color and blend it. Eyeshadow is all about building and blending. Make that a tongue twister. Blending. I don't know, I can't say. So anyway, coming to the topic. I mean, that's beautiful, right? I don't mind it. So I'm just going to add a little on the outer edge and I'm going to diffuse that into the brow. I want the outer edge to be a little deeper because I want to go in with a blue on the crease. So I'm just going to add that dark pink and pack that on the outer edge. I wish there was a purple in here so that it... I mean, I'm just wishing colors so that my look will get complete. But I mean, this is a beautiful color combination. 9 colors, really bright colors. You can do like 100, like not even 100, 1,000 different looks with this. So, and I'm just going to pack that color on the outer edge. So now I'm just going to first cut the crease. So for the concealer, again, I'm going in with the Maybelline. Cut the crease, look up words. Wherever the mark is, finish the look. So I take the, you know, concealer a little outwards so that I can put the outer edge color and blend it into it so that we can, you know, pop and blend really well. Going back in with the dark pink and blending the edges. You can see that, you know, that it's getting diffused into a lighter pink. So make sure you pack it on really well so that the color stays and it doesn't look like a lighter shade of pink. Now, if you want to enhance the color even more, you can go in with that orange and go around that crease area just to, you know, enhance that a little more. Looks really right. So after this, now where's the blue? So next I'm just going to use these two blue metallics. First I'm going to add this, then I'm going to add it in the inner corner like a lighter gradient from darker blue to lighter blue. So I'm just first picking up this shade on a brush. I mean, I don't have a hope to use the brush with these because they are metallics and metallics perform a lot better with the finger always. But I just want to see how they perform with the brush. So I mean, not bad, but let me just use my hand instead. I mean, it's definitely taking a while to get that blue on properly, but it is there, you can definitely see it. So just for precision, I'm going to go in back with the brush and I'm going to add it on the end. So now I'm going to go in with this lighter shade of blue and I'm going to pop that in the starting. I'm blending that light blue into that dark blue. It's been a minute I did a very colorful look and I'm loving how it's turning out. Now the blue, dark blue kind of just disappeared, so I'm going in back with that and I'm adding that. So I'm not really liking the finish on the edge of the blue. So what I'm going to do is, it's just because pink and blue of course don't mix well together, so I'm just going to go in with this dark brown shade from the Autumn Mix palette, and I'm just going to add that on the edge and diffuse it. I hope I don't ruin this. Now it looks a lot better. I'm just going to blend that brown properly out into that pink. Looks pretty, right? I'm just going to do the other eye off camera and I'll be right back. The other eye is done. Now for low lash line, I do want to go in with the same red and buff it out with the pink. So I'm just taking a tiny brush and I'm going to add that. Basically, I'm just going to continue that same color on the lower lash line as well. I'm going to be very precise with the application. Now I'm just going back in with that lighter shade and I'm going to blend the edges. I just want to clean up the edges a little bit. I should have added tape, but I'm just going in with my Maybelline powder and I'm just going to draw a straight line. I'm not really doing this for baking, but to get that precise line. So now for inner corner, I am confused. I want to go in with that yellow, but I feel I will ruin it, so I am not sure what I'm going to do. What do you guys think? Like, of course you guys can't tell me, but now we have come this far, so why not go in with the yellow as well? I don't have hopes for yellow because yellow is a pretty difficult color to impress. I don't like the yellow in the James Charles palette. I don't like the yellow in the Jeffree Star Jawbreaker palette. Ayn Brand palette has really good yellow. Good Beauty by Ayn Brand. Ayn Bright palette. So this yellow, and it's not that bright yellow, so it might be good, but let's see. So I'm just going to go in with that. Pray for me, guys. Let me just add it on the left, and if it's nice, then we'll go into the right, or else I'm going to take off like some earbud and rub it off. It's not that bad. I mean, it's not that strong. I think we have a success here. So I'm just taking my highlighter and I'm going to add that on that, hoping that it will make it pop. I don't know. I don't think I like it. No. And I think I'm ruining it now. I'm just going to go in back with that yellow. So until now, I like all the shades except the blue, this dark shimmery blue. I love this light blue metallic, but I don't like the dark blue because I feel it's very flaky. I mean, it's not sticking that well. It looks beautiful like once you build it up, but if you go a little close and see, it's not that good. So I'm just going to, you know, swatch that so that you'll understand. Like, it's not that it's not that great, while the other blue shimmer is like really good. You can see the difference, right, what I'm saying? So, you know, this is like a very proper shimmer compared to the blue, and it doesn't look bad, but you know, I am reviewing it, so I need to tell you guys. So the look is almost done. I just have to pop on liner, lashes, and then I'll give you all the swatches and my final thoughts and my review on the other two palettes as well. So yeah guys, that is the completed look. Don't mind my hair. I wanted to curl it, but now it's neither curled nor straight. So in the waterline, I just added this Essence Long Lasting Eye Pencil in turquoise, and I added the Bronzen Pack M75. It's weird that they have the packs number, but these are Bronzen lashes and Pack M72 lashes. Let's start off with this palette. I absolutely love it. I do think it's worth $600, and you really, really get good matte colors. I'm surprised the mattes are better than the shimmer. Like, I only tried these two shimmers, but I love this one. This one's a little flaky, but the mattes are beautiful, dude. Look at my eyes. It looks really beautiful. Now, anytime anybody asks me a good, affordable eyeshadow, colorful eyeshadow, I would definitely recommend this.
That's just a heads up. They swatch very terribly but work very beautiful on the eye.
Now next, coming to Mocha Mix, I'm going to add a clip right here when I tried this eyeshadow palette. That tutorial is going to be on my IGTV really, really soon, so stay tuned for that. Really beautiful palette, such a beautiful color pattern. You have cool tone brown, a little warm brown, a little warm pink. I mean, it's a beautiful, beautiful palette. Like, this is my favorite palette. And then we have the Autumn Spice palette. This palette I used a couple of times. Like, I didn't really do an entire look with this, but I used it in my previous YouTube video as well, and I really enjoy it. It's a warm palette, so if you are into warm shades, then you should definitely give this a try. So let's talk about pros and cons of the palette. Pros is the pricing. $5.99 for one palette and $9.99 for three palettes. I don't know if they have the offer going on right now, but like when I bought, it's $999, and I'm sure it might come back again. So pricing is pro number one, and the color, I love the mattes. Like, most of the mattes are really, really, really beautiful, and the color, you know, placement, really beautiful colors. I really love how they coordinate each other. And number four is that they're available in India, really good quality. And coming to the cons, the only problem I had with one shade is that metallic blue. It was a little flaky. I mean, looks beautiful, but that's one thing I wanted to point. So that brings us to the end of today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I hope you found the answer of whether you need to try these palettes or not. Like, if you were considering of buying these palettes and you were skeptical, then that was my review. You can decide now if you want to buy these palettes or not. I think they're really worth it. And if you enjoyed the video, then make sure you like, share and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell. And yeah guys, I actually want, you know, you guys to even suggest video ideas. So do let me know in the comments below. I would really like, you know, to make those videos for you guys. So yeah, that's it for today. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!